higher order derivatives. We're going to talk about second and higher order derivatives. So first of all, a second derivative would be noted as f double prime of x, or in Leibniz notation, it has a d the second y over dx2, and this is just notation meaning the second derivative. Or we could take the Leibniz notation for the first derivative, dy by dx, and say d by dx of this, so taking a derivative of the derivative, and that's essentially what the second derivative means, is find the derivative and then find the derivative of that derivative. We could also denote it as y double prime using differential operators. We would put a little 2 here, or using differential operator derivative with respect to x, putting a little 2. Now, if we wanted a third order derivative, meaning a third derivative, we could do that by putting another prime on here. This would become a 3 and a 3. Actually, this one would be a derivative, the second derivative's derivative. And here we could put a second derivative and then take another derivative. We would put 3 primes here. We would make this a 3. Or this a 3. So we could continue with that if we wanted a fourth derivative or a fifth derivative, but starting to put those little primes in there after 3 gets to be too many. So essentially we put the nth derivative, so this could be a 4, a 5, a 6, a 25. We actually put it in parentheses, and then we know it's not an exponent, it's a derivative. So this would be the nth derivative of y, or we could take the n minus 1 derivative of y and then take a derivative of that, and essentially we would then have the nth derivative of y. With Leibniz notation, we would put it, for example, if this was a fifth derivative, we would put a 5 here, and we would put a 5 here. With differential operator notation, we would put a 5 there, or whatever order derivative we would like. So let's do this and figure out a second derivative. So the first thing we would need to do is find the first derivative. And so we know that is the limit as h approaches 0 of the function at x plus h. So that'd be x plus h squared plus 3 times x plus h minus the function at x, and that whole thing over h. So let's go ahead and simplify this. So we have the limit as h approaches 0. If we multiply this, we have x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. Distributing the 3, 3x plus 3h. Distributing the negative here, we have negative x squared minus 3x, and all that is over h. We can see that these 3x minus 3x cancel, and this x squared minus x squared cancel. And so we now have the limit as h approaches 0 of, I'm going to factor out an h. That leaves me 2x plus h plus 3, and that's over h. And so the h's will cancel, and now I can take the limit as h goes to 0. So this would go to 0, and I'd be left with 2x plus 3. So that is the first derivative. So if we want the second derivative, we would take the derivative of this derivative. So that would be the limit as h approaches 0 of 2, putting x plus h in the function, plus 3 minus the function at x, all over h. So that would be the limit as h approaches 0 of 2x plus 2h plus 3 minus 2x minus 3 over h. And we can see that the x terms cancel, and 3 minus 3 canceling the h terms. The second derivative then of this function equals 2. Now remember that when we talked about the instantaneous rate of change of position, that was velocity. And so the derivative of position with respect to time is the velocity function. You think about this, if the change in position with the change in time, that could be miles per hour, meters per second, etc., and we would get velocity. So we could have a constant velocity moved along at a constant. We could have a negative velocity. When the velocity has a negative sign on it, it's moving in the opposite direction. We could talk about acceleration when the velocity is changing, and if you changed it very quickly, a large change in acceleration would cause you to jerk. If you were riding along in a car and you just accelerated very quickly or decelerated very quickly, you would get jerked around, and that is called jerk derivative of the acceleration. And then if we just tried to figure out what was going on here, that's just berserk. That's not a math word. So if we're looking to see how the velocity is changing, that is acceleration. So that would be a derivative of velocity. If we're looking to see how the acceleration is changing, that is called jerk. So that would be a derivative of acceleration. Therefore, here is our connection. Acceleration is the derivative of velocity, so that means it's the second derivative of position. And jerk is the derivative of acceleration with respect to time, and so that means derivative of acceleration would be the second derivative of velocity, or the third derivative of position.